Hi everyone, welcome back to the Scriptcase Macros course. Today we're looking at the SC field disabled macro. So my name is Nate Carpenter and I'm the Scriptcase instructor leading this course. So let's go ahead and look at what this macro does. So it's a pretty basic macro. It just disables the input on one or more fields. So we just pass through the field names and it will gray them out so that the user can't enter anything. So here's the documentation for it. We can pass through the field name, and then we can pass through true or false to enable or disable it. So it's false by default, it's disabled by default, or we pass through true and it will enable it. And then we can pass through some parameters to determine when that will be enabled or disabled. So the parameter is optional. We can pass through I to enable it on insert, and then U for it to be valid on update. And if it is not passed through, then it's going to be disabled on both of them. So here's an example that's just disabling it on both insert and update. And this is also for insert and update, but it's enabling it there. And then here you can pass through multiple ones by putting a semicolon between them. And then the U for update as the second option. Let's go ahead and copy this first one here and take it over to Scriptcase here. So I have a form set up, just a basic form with a few fields, a rental date and a return date. So this is for some sort of rental with return comments. So some of these fields are going to be disabled on insert and some of them disabled on update. So the rental date is only valid on an insert, since that is when the rental is created. And then the return date is only going to be valid on an update and the return condition comments as well. So we're going to gray those out on an insert. So let's go to events and onload. So this is when the record is loading. And we can look at what is there. So there's our code that we copied from the documentation. And we need to look at if rental date is set. So we're going to pass through that rental date field right there. And on update. So this is on update, it's going to disable that rental date since it's already set there. So when we run this, it should be grayed out already. And there we go, that rental date field is grayed out. We click it, we can't do anything with it. If we go to add new though, it is enabled like so. So now we need to disable return date and return condition comments. So this one, we're going to go ahead and duplicate this line. And we're going to do two fields at a time so we can do those semicolons between the fields. So the first one is return date. So let me modify the name of this field here. So return date and then semicolon return comments. Return underscore comments is the name of that field. And this is going to be on the insert event. So this is when they are inserting a record. So let's go ahead and run this, and when we click add new, those two fields will be disabled. So rental date is still disabled, click add new. Now rental date is enabled and return date and return condition comments are disabled. So that's how you use SC field disabled to enable and disable fields in Scriptcase applications.